Okay, now switch back.
Oh, okay, there we go. Okay.
Okay.
So, okay, yeah. So here's, I'll show you kind of one of the projects we're working on. This is kind of the main website for Planetary Guardians right now. This is just like the login screen. It's basically an entry point for a bunch of different software platforms that we're building. One of them right now is basically, we're calling it a chat stream or like a platform, like, yeah, it's a communications platform. And what you're seeing here is really basic, right? This is the screen that they see before the actual technology. So this allows them to manage their groups and stuff like that, right? They can manage their team.
You're going too quick. You're going too quick.
Okay. As you can see, this doesn't look great, right? It's not very responsive. I should say that I'm kind of the lead programmer on this, and I'm a pretty good back-end programmer, but I'm not that great at design. So we're hoping to get someone in who can kind of make this look better. But as I say, this is just one of our projects, one of our products, you could say. So choosearemedy.com, this website is already basically, it's mostly finished. It's up and running, and we expect a lot of traffic. And again, it could use an upgrade in the look. I put the design together, and it's not responsive or anything, but just to show you mechanically how it works, this is kind of like an Oracle. So, you know, like we could say, like, just ask a question. I hope I'm spelling that right.
Yeah.
And so kind of you can ask a question and it gives you an answer based on these three cards. But there's around 400 cards to choose from. Elijah has created these card sets already. And they're part of a whole greater system, including the background picture behind him, for instance, and many other pieces. So he's created an entire software suite, and we're kind of building parts of it right now. So this would be one part. But as you can see, you know, if I change the size, you know, it's not very responsive. Could use some serious work in the design portion of it. So that could be something else that you're working on, or that you could do some work on. Because I'm not great at that. I'm kind of jumping around here, but one of the things, you know, obviously you must have read an ad and we talked about it on LinkedIn, is like, we're hoping for someone to jump in for a few hours a week and help us out with some of the stuff. And in return, we can, you know, endorse you on LinkedIn, endorse some of your skills, write you a good recommendation, you know, help you with your portfolio. You can put stuff that you built for us on your portfolio. So that's kind of what we can offer in exchange at this point.
Okay.
But we have a lot of different pieces we're building, and we're also working with this organization called the CL. They're basically 144 people they've gathered, and they're a lot of different professional abilities. There's Netflix producers, there's some best-selling authors, there's a lot of business owners and other people of note in the groups, and we're going to They're testing the technology for us for free. Like, we're giving it to them for free. And in return, we're getting some free testing, basically. So, and I'm sure they'll be helping us out, kind of roll it out on a bigger scale after the test is finished. So I just wanted to mention that, because we have kind of clients already set up for this and testing pool. And here's another kind of piece that we've made. It allows you to create kind of the conditions of the actual chat stream. So one of the facilitator teams could set up their chat room, chat stream like this. And you'll see that it uses the same card set as well. So everything ties into kind of a bigger picture in these software platforms. But at this point, we're looking for someone to take one of these projects on, or a piece of one of these projects, and kind of, you know, help make it look better. Because this is not responsive either. You know, if I change it, gets broken really fast and stuff.
Okay, yeah. I guess all the logic is being done in PHP, since I see that that's what's coming back, right?
Yeah, oh, very observant, yes. So I built it with just HTML5, CSS3, you know, a little bit of jQuery, but there's no React or anything involved. I don't know enough about React to jump into it. And then the back end is just PHP, yeah.
Okay, well, sure, okay. And just from the briefing that you've gave me, basically it's a suite of different platforms, and each of them are kind of related to one another, I'm guessing.
Yeah, okay. They're all related to a larger software system that Elijah has already completely built. We're actually now building the software version of it. Because even these card sets, he's putting them out to the world in actual physical card decks, and also probably board game and other things as well. So, but on the tech side, we're building the online software to also roll out the system.
Okay, well, that's pretty cool. Okay, and for front end, are you you're primarily looking for a lot of UI modifications when it needs to be, and I guess if you have any let's say very new ideas, you would like them all to be integrated and responsive to mobile tablets and desktops, or just mainly desktops and mobile?
Yeah, I mean, one thing we're looking into is as well as developing actual mobile apps. But for now, yeah, we're hoping to make the websites themselves responsive for tablets and mobile, as well as desktop.
Oh, wow. Okay. Any other tech or specific libraries you're using for frontend, like Bootstrap or?
No, we're open to using different libraries. I'm familiar with, you know, Vue and Angular and React. I just don't have a lot of training in them. And yeah, Bootstrap is pretty useful. I've just used jQuery and regular JavaScript just to keep it simple. But as the, you know, front end person, if you want to change the library or change the way some of that works, that's totally in your, in you know, we're open to that as well if you think it's going to improve things.
Okay.
Like React, for example, is going to look a lot better than jQuery.
Just did a call.
Yeah, I guess so. Yeah, I guess it would. But React also has some components that might not be very friendly, unless if you want it to be like different components that load live individually. Otherwise, it could be a burden if you have a lot of data that you're using.
Okay.
But that's what Redux is for. But just vanilla JavaScript and HTML, I guess, should be more than enough for what the platform is, from what I've seen at least.
I think you're probably right. Yeah, that's why I didn't really get too complicated with it. It's mostly just the layout and, what we're building is not, you know, structurally, it's not that crazy, but the actual software itself is unique that we're building, of course.
Yeah, for sure.
But yeah, so I mean, yeah, it could, as far as like what you could do for us, you could, you know, any one of these projects, obviously we need help with, but we have other components of the overall software suite that we haven't even really put into code yet.
Oh, okay.
So depending on, yeah, so what would be your preference? Kind of like what's more exciting to you, working on, you know, one of these and making it look better, or working from another kind of component that we have to start from scratch?
Yeah, I mean, I don't mind doing either one. I guess whatever projects you guys want to focus on, I could also pivot my focus to contribute. Doing projects from scratch do sound very exciting, especially being involved in a lot of the initial planning. But yeah, either way, I'm very flexible, to be very honest.
Okay.
I do want to know, how does the scheduling look like with different time zones, and if we're meeting, let's say, once a week or so, and we're planning for the work, and how's the work being tracked?
Yeah, I guess as far as the meetings go, it's actually pretty easy with you in particular, because you're in the same time zone as Elijah, and I'm used to meeting with him, so we'll be able to you know, schedule ones around this time if it works better for you, or earlier in the day. It doesn't matter. That's an easy one. Yeah, as far as contributing, we don't have GitHub set up or anything like that.
Okay.
If you wanted to work on one of these projects, I would just give you the FTP access to the server, and you could kind of work with the live version. But that being said, we do probably want to set it up on GitHub at some point here, and you know, get a little more heavy in that, because that's obviously easier. As far as tracking the work and everything, we haven't gone as far as using Trello or anything, but that's kind of on the table as well. We have Discord. In between the meetings, you can just like shoot us a question. We're usually on, one of us is usually online there.
Mm-hmm.
And then the weekly meeting. Okay. And we're just kind of starting to, you know, I just put that ad out a few days ago. We're just kind of starting to try to integrate a front end person. So, you know, if it works better for you to use this or that, or you really want to use Trello or something, we can do that too.
Well, no, Rike. Rike, we'll be using Rike.
Rike?
Yeah, have you ever used Rike?
How do I spell that? I don't think I have.
W-R-I-K-E. I have to activate that soon.
Okay, yeah. I could look into it. But I'm pretty flexible with whatever you would want to use for project management.
Okay. Yeah. I mean, at this point, we can keep it kind of casual. And as soon as, you know, we know what project you're working on and then what kind of goals we're trying to set, then we can obviously put more structure to it.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Okay.
So, okay. I guess I'm gathering that you're interested. It sounds like a cool project.
Yeah, sounds very cool. Finding a few hours in a week is very simple. So, it sounds very cool to actually be involved in this project.
Cool. Okay. I think it is really, really neat.
Like, just jump in and ask a few questions, Ezekiel.
Sure, absolutely.
So, like, where are you in your life? Like, kind of in your career and your life, and.
Sure. Yeah. Right now, I'm trying to get my certificates in cybersecurity. These are professional certificates, and so I'm using as many resources as I can to study for those exams, and some exams sometimes take a whole year to study for. I've just recently finished a job with iComply Investor Services, where I worked in quality assurance. And primarily we worked with several technologies. We had a web-based technology, both front end was using React and the back end was using C#, .NET. So I mainly worked on the .NET tech stack, doing a lot of in-house tools. So like our API monitoring tool, which was pretty critical actually to being able to track how much user sessions we're having, and also kind of try to prevent any future crashes since when we were scaling up, we were having a few more API crashes, which were really bad for business. And actually I had never worked on C# before that. So that was me picking up C# while I was working at that company, and it ended up being pretty good. So I'm at the phase where I'm still studying a lot because I like learning new technologies, but also, diving into actual professional work is something that I continue to pursue. My term ended with iComply, so whichever company I can pick up sounds great. But when I saw the ad, I was like, "Oh, okay, this sounds very interesting." So I applied as well. Yeah.
Right on.
Are you currently working right now, or not?
No, I'm not right now.
Okay. And what about like in terms of this cybersecurity, like is that the pathway you're aiming for to be more of a security expert?
Yes. I do want to cater my software development skills towards application security. And so that's why I would like to do as much concentration as possible in studying for the certifications. But it doesn't really take me away from all the other work that I do love, while with JavaScript or anything else like that.
Because like one of the most important parts, I think, of what we're doing at some point is going to be the security. And I've always thought you should be doing that kind of like at the beginning, at the get-go. And if you have, like, it depends. Some people, they're going that way because they want to learn about it. Some people, they already know about it. They want to learn more. Some people are just naturally gifted at it. What would be very valuable would be to look at the whole thing we're doing from a security point of view, and maybe even the beginning of conceptually, you know, how can we make this as secure as possible? And I know that, you know, Nov has his own ideas, and everyone has their own ideas, but for me personally, it's got, to me, it's like one of the most important things. And from the get-go, I want to be as much security as possible. So that's an angle that maybe can go towards, again, your portfolio, getting some experience and looking at from a very beginning, you know, how to look at sort of setting up procedures and, and protocols in terms of what we're going to be doing. So that's one thing. I'm just wondering, like, in terms of your own specialty of what you've done with what you're saying here, the API crashes, is that something we'll have to worry about in the future? Or?
With PHP is pretty versatile. So, I mean, I don't think so. It was meant to handle quite a few requests. It's just for us at the previous company that I worked for. We didn't necessarily cater to very specific inputs that users were using, because it's a compliance company, right? Wow. And so we also had some machine learning modules in there. Like, for example, our OpenCV library, which is a computer vision library, would often be the one that initiates the crash, right? And so I think that's actually why we had a lot of the crashes. We just had so much processing to do. And some of our instances weren't creating new ones in real time. So, like, we're just having situations like that all the time. But I don't think it had anything to do specifically with the endpoints, but rather the data crunching that it was doing in the background. Nova probably knows a lot more of what's going on in the back end. I don't know too much. And so in my opinion, I think it's pretty fine, but Nova would be able to elaborate a whole lot more on that.
Okay. Where would you say your expertise is?
I'm very flexible.
Let me ask you a different question. Yeah. You just strike me as someone, it sounds like you got a lot of front end experience, obviously some back end experience as well, and you're moving towards a security thing, like, and just in general, you seem pretty confident. What would you say if I asked you, if you, instead of doing some of the, you know, front end stuff mainly, what would you be interested in, like, maybe doing a project management role?
Project management, it's like pretty that, good. Is that it's something that I would be interested in along the line in the future. But I do like development, and if it is front end, then it's front end.
Okay.
So yeah, like, I would definitely leave all the back end stuff to you. I would need a lot more experience in order to cater to something that's a very big project, but I am very flexible in going either way.
Okay, because I'm just saying that because we do have, you know, a few people who've decided that they wanted to jump into some of the front end stuff, and now we've got the job of actually organizing people and as part of your interest, would that interest you at all, is like kind of managing some of the other people with you and doing the front end altogether?
Yeah, absolutely. I definitely don't mind doing a project management role. It still has a lot to do with the product's lifecycle. So I definitely would be interested.
Okay, well, that's cool. Okay, just throwing that out there.
Yeah, absolutely.
Do you see what's behind me?
Yes, I do.
Could you reproduce that?
That specific image?
Yeah. If you were just given this image, could you take this image and then make the wheels turn in programming?
That's a lot of CSS. I would probably need some time to review what's required to do that in CSS, but right now I would say that I've never made anything that's complex with CSS animations.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the piece behind them is a pretty big piece, but at the same time, it's going to be complicated to make that move.
Yes. I've seen some very complex CSS projects, and though a very simple like marking type of language, it still has its own complexities for sure.
Yeah. Okay. Well. Interesting. Well, yeah. I mean, we're obviously, I think I can speak for Elijah. Like, we'd love to have you on the team. You seem like you could probably help us out a lot, and you're interested in the project, and I think the project is pretty cool. Elijah will definitely agree with that. It's got a lot of potential, and yeah, various kind of components of it are all pretty interesting actually to work on.
Mm-hmm. For sure.
So okay, so you're mainly studying these days. So you told me on LinkedIn like you're looking after your dad.
That's correct. Yes, I am definitely taking care of him full time.
Okay, fair enough. So yeah, I mean, we would we'd totally be able to work around your hours kind of thing and try to get something together that would suit your time.
Absolutely.
Okay. Do you got any other questions for us at this point, kind of thing?
No, not too many. You guys were talking about the potential for the project to kind of grow exponentially. Do you think that you would then need to kind of cater your technical infrastructure in order to meet those type of demands? And if so, would we, sorry, I'm losing my train of thought, but would the organization itself be restructured based on, let's say, the different types of teams that would be catering to different types of projects? Because there's multiple components within a really big platform, right? And so are we going to try and concentrate on various parts, or are we going to work on them all at the same time, or are specific individuals going to be assigned to a specific component of the larger platform?
I think the short answer to that is it's kind of all in the works right now. Mm-hmm. And you know, it all eventually has to be built. There's a couple components right now that we're focusing on because as I said, the other group that we're working on, the CL, we're building some software specifically for them right now. So obviously that's a bit of a priority, but project management and this and the entire kind of structure of how we're going to do all the work together is still kind of being put on the table. So if you sound like someone who could actually help us figure that out, that's why I asked you the project management question earlier. I have some ideas. Obviously, Laj has got some ideas. Like, we should set up a GitHub. You know, we need Reich or some sort of project management system. You know, mm-hmm. We've got our Discord. But yeah, we do have a growing number of people who are trying to get involved. Like, to answer your other question, it's definitely going to be growing exponentially. Once we get the software completed for LaCielle, it's going to probably take on a whole other level here for us. And we're going to be wanting to do a lot of stuff professionally and organized way.
Oh, okay, perfect. Yeah. Oh, one last question I totally forgot. You said that since you guys haven't set up a GitHub yet, you would be able to give me access to the FTP server. Would I need any specific web servers installed on my PC in order to make any modifications on the front end?
No, I mean, at this point, if you got like Notepad++ or something, that's enough. CyberDoc or any kind of FTP program, and then your own editor is fine. Basically, I just give you a clone of whatever you're working on, mm-hmm. and you can, you know, deal with the live version there of that. And then once it's, you know, we'll kind of, you know, sort of like a fake GitHub. So, you know, mm-hmm. once you get a different look or something finished, we can move it to the live site. But yeah, basically you just need, you know, an FTP client and whatever editor you want.
Okay, perfect. Yeah, that sounds good to me.
Okay. Elijah, what do you think at this point? You got any more questions?
Just that it's the whole idea is a thinking system. And the tool, the main operating system, is called the Inflow Matrix operating system. Mm-hmm. And then there's something called the New Paradigm Toolkit. And there's card sets, maps, game boards, processes, and software. Mm-hmm. So we're bringing together offline stuff and online stuff. Mm-hmm. I've got a six set card deck that has conscious communication types, mm-hmm. convo types, and values. And then the other four card sets are multi-layered from the inner you, to the inner group, to the outer group. So it's using systems thinking to organize conceptual models that we're going to use for to build software and to have offline tools that integrate together.
Okay.
So there's a lot behind this. I put 25 years of design into this. Mm-hmm. So this is what we showed you are just pieces of this puzzle, but there's a lot more behind it, and it all integrates into this new cyclical timing system.
Yeah.
So okay. if you're thinking longer term and you really, you know, the more you understand about the idea, the more you'll get why the software is going in a certain way and what the language is about.
Mm-hmm. So yeah.
So the, you know, for all of the people involved, each person is going to kind of go to their level of commitment, their level of awareness, their level of how much they want to become involved. Mm-hmm. And to me, because at the stage it's at now, like it's very open. It's very yeah. open. It's and one of the main ideas down the road is you design your ideal job. Mm-hmm. You design exactly, you know, what you love to do. Bring your gifts in, and that's how everyone is working together. So,
okay,
there's a much bigger big picture here, kind of thing.
Absolutely, and it does sound pretty exciting.
Yeah. When I started working with Elijah, I didn't really understand what we were doing. But over the last year or so, I've been very excited about what's happening.
Absolutely. It is a yeah. project.
Mm-hmm. And just to be completely on a level, like me and Elijah are not, we're actually volunteers too, essentially. Like Elijah's the one who created all this. And I've just been doing the programming kind of as a volunteer role, I suppose. Mm-hmm. But just because I can understand the potential of it, I would like to see the software go out, and I know that down the road this is going to be something that that will draw income, you know, that will be able to pay me and other people. So I'm pretty stoked.
Yeah, for sure. Absolutely.
So, and we have I don't know if we said much about Lucille, but we actually have a test group of 144 people with 12 teams of 12 people mm-hmm. that in 2 weeks are waiting for the software program to work. And so that's going to be Nova's main chore. We are very close to having it done.
I'll be finishing that soon. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So,
but at the same time, it's going to look terrible.
It doesn't look terrible.
It's going to look terrible. It looks basic. Is the thing, like this is the main thing of it. This particular screen looks okay, but it's, you know, it's not responsive. And that's kind of what I hate about it. It will work for them. They're going to test it for us. Mm-hmm. They know that we're building this, you know, without any money for them to test. And that after that, you know, that's something that you could work on or someone could work on, is like, make this look like, you know, ready for market product, where it's right now it's a functional product, but you know, ready for market is kind of where we're going, of course.
Absolutely.
Yeah. And of course, any input from your side on, let's say, conceptual design or what pieces you think are missing, as we go along with everyone, I think people will start to, you know, it's a very creative project. The idea mm-hmm. is to stimulate and inspire everyone to really get involved in some way, that we're building something beautiful here and everyone has the chance to really jump in. So.
Yeah, absolutely. I think along the line, as we continuously progress, and then I kind of dive into the platforms and I kind of understand the whole entire idea and its complexity, I think definitely a lot of inputs. I mean, you'll be hearing a lot of inputs from what I think, you know, things, yeah, for sure.
Well, we would definitely welcome that for sure. I guess there's two different things kind of that we could do next. One is, you know, I got to set up, I'll set you up with an FTP account, and I'll, if you shoot me your LinkedIn, or your email on LinkedIn, I'll send you an email later today with just the FTP credentials, or possibly tomorrow. I gotta do some stuff with the server, but that's one thing. And then, you know, maybe have a meeting again tomorrow or the next day or something, just to, you know, start off the projects, you know, decide on something that you can start on and everything. Sure. And the other kind of route that we can go here is maybe, you know, you and Elijah need to sit down for half hour, hour, one of these days in the next week, and just kind of explain the whole program, the whole system to you.
That'll be great. Yeah.
It sounds like that you're open to getting your head around it, which is obviously going to be helpful in the development end as well. In the end, if you've got to understand the product, then you're going to be a better designer for it anyway.
Exactly. Yes, I truly believe that.
Yeah. Okay. So what would you rather do first? Would you rather sit down with Elijah at some point and like go through the actual whole project, or do you want to get it right into the code and start messing with it right away?
I would probably want to do the sit down first, kind of understand the whole entire project, and get in as quick as possible into the project, and then just start going through it and seeing where I can go or anywhere that's assigned. But yeah, okay. I would like an understanding of the project. So if we could have a sit down and then, you know, go through each platform one by one, and maybe like go through the design thoughts, then, or actually, sorry, the user experience, you know, where is everything supposed to be? What's the user supposed to feel when they're in this particular page? Things like that. It will definitely help when it comes to getting in there and actually developing some of the components.
Great. Okay. Yeah, and like I say, I'm kind of a lead programmer at this point, and obviously focusing on the back end. But yeah, Elijah's obviously the one to sit down with as far as that, all that kind of stuff goes, I would think.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I guess the next step then is me and you sitting down having a chat. Is that?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Maybe on Monday.
Monday. I could probably do Monday evening, like after 5 p.m. or so. If you're available on weekends, I could do mornings or after 5 p.m. as well.
I can do I can do Monday at 6 or 7. Is that
sure? Yeah. Yeah. Absolutely.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. Let's do
Monday.
Okay, I can send you guys my email in chat, or I could actually, I'll send it to Nova on LinkedIn, and then you can share it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Perfect. And I'll hold off on sending you all the FTP stuff and all that kind of stuff until you have time to sit down here.
Sure.
And then, yeah. Maybe later on Monday, I'll send you that stuff or whatever.
Perfect. Yeah, but I'm definitely interested in joining. Would like to get a feel of the concept, the design concepts. Yeah.
Well, you could go to choosearemedy.com, and that's the one.
That'd be great.
It's accessible.
Actually, maybe even a few links that I could just look into tonight.
I'll link those. Yeah. I'll send a few links here on LinkedIn.
Perfect.
Okay, well, awesome.
Thank you guys for this interview.
Okay, well, yeah.
Thanks
for coming on. And
great to meet you.
Look forward to more meetings, and I'll be very interested to hear what happens after Monday.
Yes, cool. Absolutely. I'm excited for
either way, welcome to the team.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, guys.
Okay.
Take care.
All right. Thank you. Okay. That went the other direction. I liked it.
So that's six?
That is six, I believe now. Wait, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yep. So yeah, I don't know if you caught that, but he's expecting us to have user experience write-ups and like written write-ups on all the pieces of the project and how it all fits together and stuff. So I would try to, I don't know, plan your Monday meeting carefully, I guess, in a way that's, you know, just be frank with them. You'd be like, I got all this figured out. I just don't know.
I'll overwhelm him with maps.
Well, yeah, I don't think he's going to get the whole concept in the first meeting anyway, so I'm sure he'll be fine.
Okay, so we got one at 9, and by then I've got to have something ready for him, right? Have you got him set up on FTP yet, or we haven't done that yet?
No, this guy, we're going to wait until after your meeting with him.
Not.
And then I'll have it set up.
Are you talking about Sunday?
Oh, sorry. No, I was talking about Zeke.
No, but I'm talking about Sunil.
Sunil. Oh, yeah. We're meeting him. I'm meeting him in half an hour. Yeah, I've got a bare bones. Nothing.
No, 9. I thought he's at 9.
I'll confirm with him right now while we're talking.
Okay.
Either 8 or 9, I guess. What time is it? Yeah, either 8:15 or 9:15, but I will double check with him right now.
Do you know when people don't ask for what they want, you know they want something. They won't ask for it, but they're hedging around everything to do it. And by being bratty, you keep on, they know that you know. But you're waiting for them to say it. You're waiting for them to come out with it, but they won't come out with it for whatever reason. And so then you kind of give insinuating things. They're sort of poking at them because you want them to come out and say it, but they won't say it.
Well, yeah. what were you reading from that one that he wasn't saying?
Oh no, I'm not talking about him. I'm talking about Brooke. I think she wants a ride to the ferry, and she wants the set of the maps. But she.
okay.
But she's
beating around the bush.
What was I saying? She goes, I think I might leave Vancouver tonight. So this is 5:23. And then I go, your van beckons you. And it's true, but I want one of those dang boards. And I said, which one? And she goes, the time ones. And I said, there are several of them. She goes in capitals. I know that. You said you want one of those dang boards. So I didn't understand. Like, what do you want? You want like one board, or you want the time maps? Because she wants, I know what she wants. She wants me to come pick her up, take her to the ferry with the time maps, right?
Yeah.
Then she, and there's like 15 minutes in between each message. So it's not like right away. She's like, she's in this kind of state. Then I go, Kat got your tongue. She goes, yeah. I think it's because I got to start playing the medically exempt card again. Anyway, so then I'm in a call. I got a call at 9. I don't feel like picking her up and driving her to the fair. I don't have the time to do it because of this stuff. And it's, you know, as this gets more serious, right? You got to make more and more decisions around where you put your time. And usually other people these days are the ones that don't get it, even though I told her I would give her the maps. The maps cost like $50 to print 11 maps both sides. And I print I printed five of them, five sets. And I want to give them in the hands of people that are going to use them. And I think she will, but I'm not so sure. I want her to want them. Because if she doesn't really want them, she's not going to use them.
Right.
You understand what I'm talking about?
I kind of get what you're saying. I get what you're throwing down.
No, you don't.
I get what you're saying.
It's just, she's been hanging with Jordan. When I asked, did they do any planetary, my whole assessment system is if they're doing something with planetary guardians, right? So Brooke, to me, is an example of young divine feminine, planetary guardian, and she hasn't reached that place yet. Like, I want her, like, to be a planetary guardian reporter. You know, she's got great, very intelligent, does great downloads. Like, when she gives a download, she fucking gives a lot of different information at the same time, like, very concisely when she's assessing something. Very good. She's very funny.
Yeah.
But her and Jordan, I don't... I think they're slackers.
Well, it's a good thing this is recorded.
Yeah. Jordan knows it. I made this job thing assessment and flake. It goes flake. It goes like douchebag, loser.
Oh, flake, I've seen that. Yeah.
Okay. That. Solid and hero. And I've been telling him you're in the flake. I you're in this position. I sent the chart to him and I said, this is where you are. And so I haven't taken him out of that yet. So because he's in that, and then she comes in there, it's like. So these time cycles, they may actually help, or they're not going to help at all. They'll just toss them and use them for firewood.
Well, yeah, I mean.
I think
so. Neil has not responded yet either. I'll give him a few minutes.
So I know she's it's funny, eh? Like somebody could put some capital letters up and all of a sudden you realize the tone has changed. I think because she knows I'm being bratty. But you know,
yeah, someone wanted me to make a website for them. I said, yeah, okay, sure. And like they paid me already. And then they just keep missing the meetings. They keep failing to send me the logo and stuff. It's like, dude, you already paid me. What's going on here? Eventually, I'm just going to not do it.
How much did they pay you?
$300. It's like a super simple website.
What are you building in it?
It's going to be a WordPress website with 3 or 4 pages. It's going to take me 3 to 6 hours at the most.
And you got so much time. Yeah, you got to get done right now, right? What is it? We brought in Dylan.
Look at the schedule I got. What the schedule today?
Jesus.
Jesus. We got Donnie.
All this time that we got bringing new people on, we could have finished the stupid thing.
No. It's okay. We'll get it done.
We have 6 people now.
Yeah. That's why I thought, like, halfway through that conversation, like, shit, maybe this guy wants to be our project manager. We got 5 other volunteers to do.
We got a lot of.
We got 6.
That's going to get me. Like, I got to pick up my pace totally in terms of coming up with all the shit.
But yeah, that's what I'm hoping you'll realize is even just for your sit down on Monday, it should be a pretty big eye opener, I think, because he's expecting a whole bunch of stuff to be finished already and just be like, you know, here's our business plan, here's our, you know, our marketing research, our user experience data. Here's the complete plan of all the pieces, how they fit together. what they do and how it should look on paper. And now, can you please design some of this for me? That's probably his idea right now.
What he's going to get is a map. Everything's in maps, and the map is the interface. All we got to do is connect the maps together. And I like you saying, the whole thing's done. The whole thing's done. Already designed. Are you fucking kidding?
Well, it better be. It better be. I mean, you said you've been working on it for 25 years. It's time to build it. And I have to tell people that it's all finished. I mean, otherwise, who the hell is going to do this?
And you can
part of my job is the IT administrator. I also have this other job called the HR department person, I think, is what I've been turning into. And also the mission kind of liar. Also, it's all done. We just need to work on pieces. And it's going to be awesome. Let's get you on board. Let's get you started. That's kind of my approach.
I think I can speak for Elijah. I won't let him speak, but I think I can speak for Elijah that we love you. Wait a second.
Because it works.
You know what's funny is I realize, you know, how little we know what we're doing in terms of like running a good interview and thinking, holy cripe, are we ever Bush League?
Yeah.
If I was those guys, I'd go, these guys are clowns.
I can't believe so far, except for Sarah, which is, 50-50. I don't know if we got her or not, but otherwise, I think we've got 100% of the people we've interviewed to say, yeah, okay, let's do this. So I'm in.
It's pretty good. Is she number seven?
She would be number seven, yeah.
Did you? I guess we could put them on themes, right? We could have two. Have you figured out which ones are going which?
No. With Donnie and Sunil, yes.
That's two of and the five.
I'm keeping track of all this. Yeah, so Ezekiel, I'm going to wait to put him on something until you've had the talk with him, because it'll probably reveal more information about what to do.
Yeah, I was in the call. I was in the call.
There you go. That was a good call, right? Yeah. Yeah. So I'm going to wait about him. And then who else did we got? Het. I'm going to send him a link tomorrow. Or I'm going to send him a message tomorrow on LinkedIn asking him what time on Monday he could meet. So we'll have to have a project for him ready for Monday. Jeez. And then Mohammed, who I talked to, you were asleep because it was 2:30 in the morning there. He's in, and I got to get him a project. I got to meet him again in 1 hour, I think. Let me double check that, actually. I think I forgot to tell you that one.
What's that?
Oh, Sunil is ready to meet in 15 minutes. Can you send me a Zoom link or just the same one?
Who is? 15 minutes.
Yeah, he's ready to come on in 15 minutes from now. Yeah.
15 minutes.
Technically 20 minutes from now. It's 8:39.
So I got to create a new one? Why don't we just
say... just give me the link. Yeah, I've forgotten though. Which one are we on?
The 7 o'clock one.
Okay. Okay, I'll set them up.
Okay, I got to do something here.
What's that?
Hey, I made a new card set today called the Right Approach card set.
You just added another piece to the puzzle. Quit it.
Stop it.
Another entire card set. Okay, so Sunil will be the most. Oh, my internet connection is unstable. Perfect. Yeah, so what's on my list to do here is to write down notes about the volunteers and try to figure out what to do with them.
That's a good idea.
So I'm on it. Yep. Exactly. Oh, yeah, and I was going to see how many people. Let's see here.
It's like you got these seven balls. And then every time I see you, you're adding another ball. Just got all these balls.
Something like that, yeah.
Digital media. Let's
see what's going on here. 17 applicants now.
Oh, shit.
Okay.
Too new.
Some of these I sent a message to already.
I think you're good at this.
Digital marketing manager. Good. Interesting. He has 0 years experience and doesn't look very good, that one.
So you're going to send them a form letter and see who responds, kind of thing?
Yeah, I'll show you. I click on them, click message. Oh, I already sent him one. There you go. This guy said no. Because he found out it was volunteer. This guy has not responded yet. I don't think I messaged this guy. Oh, apparently I did.
I'm impressed with your background.
That's actually the one that LinkedIn automatically suggests that you use, but I copy and paste this one. Hi, Jake. We are excited that you're interested in the project. What is volunteer job? You can be sure that being able to share your work on your portfolio will help you get your next digital media dream job. So yeah, the same thing, except we'll onboard you into the Planetary Guardians media team. Boom.
If you'll work for free, we'll get you going.
You can start now.
There's a lot of God, and I can just me with my big spiel. I could have watched it. I guess that's it. I guess I'm the visionary, eh?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. The Steve Jobs kind of guy. You're the one that's walking around the tech office with 100 people working, you know, asking them, hey, man, how many times have you done acid? Fired, that's not enough.
Shut up! Get back to work.
Corporate communications and marketing.
Any from Canada?
Don't want.
We don't want.
I don't know.
How can I see these? Like, it's too small. Can you send me them over somehow, or?
No, what you'd have to do, all you need to do is just make a LinkedIn account, and then I could make you an admin, and you can manage these jobs. You can look at the resumes and everything.
I killed my LinkedIn account. I was too unsuccessful. Yeah,
okay. Well, I'll make another one.
I don't know. I took down my Twitter. I'm slowly taking down all my social media.
See, yeah, LinkedIn is a social media website, but at the same time, it's almost not. It's literally just professional stuff. So
I know
it's a good place to have yourself and just put up. So, you know, you don't have to say anything. You don't have to. In fact, you look better.
What?
You just have it as a place that people can see your face and see your picture and see, you know, whatever. You can put some stuff up about work experience if you want. Just put, you know, you could just put the creator, designer, developer, and project manager of Planetary Guardians, and then put that from you know, what, from 1996 to 2021. You know, here it is here. And then you can, you know, I can make you the admin of this. And I would suggest you don't post anything on here, but you can if you want. Because it's just a marketing front for us to get volunteers. That's all this is supposed to be at this point. Later, we'll have a media, we'll have a, you know, a media relations person, all that crap. They can handle this for us. But yeah, if you make yourself an admin or an account, I can just add you as a admin here. And then you can see all the resumes and stuff, see when they're coming in, look at their profiles and everything.
So maybe I can make a fake one.
Yeah, if you want.
Wait, I gotta get some shit done before I'm not used to all this stuff.
So for Sunil, I was thinking, remember he's working on the synergy wheel.
Yeah.
So you got that ready for him? 14 minutes?
That's what I'm getting.
Like it. I'll be right back. I got to
Hey, baby.
Guess what? It's not a new program.
So what? If she's being that much of a pain. Hey, you know what? Should have me come in as mediation.
That guy tried to phone you.
You did?
He said he phoned and there was no answer. It's just after around 6 o'clock.
Oh, you did?
And he said, and then he messaged me and said, can you tell Elijah we'll have to reschedule? So you have to figure out a way to communicate with this guy. Is he not on Messenger? Find out what if he's on Messenger or Telegram or Signal or something. Okay? So you can text message him on your phone.
So he will be on your phone?
Yes.
Okay. Honey.
I'm watching TV now. I'm
throughout the pandemic. And to be honest with you, when I did my math with Elijah, I had no idea what I was getting myself into, but I just decided to keep an open mind. I did a flow map, which focuses on the outer you. When Elijah asked me to create an intention for the map, I said my biggest dream, which was my intention, is to represent Canada at the 2026 Olympics. I'm a competitive curler. That's my biggest dream. It's always been my biggest dream. And so that's the intention that I used to go in with the map. And as I was doing the map, I was like, I have no idea how this is like gonna fit into all of this, but as I mentioned earlier, just keep an open mind. And after I did my map, I didn't really look at it at all. I kind of just, I just kept it in a folder. I look at it every few months, and I'd be like, this really doesn't make sense. Like, this doesn't apply to what I want to do. I don't see how this fits. And I looked at my map a few months ago, and bells just going off in my head. I saw how all the values that I laid out for myself and chose were really fitting. And I saw how they could play a huge role into exceeding my intention of representing Canada at the 2026 Olympics. And now that I actually see where my values really fit into my intention, I use my map all the time. I love it. I look at it a lot. And it's just really taken me to a new level, and having this faith in myself and believing that just in the process and having it all works out. And because the values that I picked for myself for my map are 2T, it's been incredible. The one thing that I really like about this sort of mapping compared to different values, to different like values exercises, is you actually pick your own values. And so what I did is I picked 20 values out of a deck of cards, and I divinely chose 10. And 9 out of 10 of the cards I chose were incredibly accurate. I think I changed one card and at one of the mapping spots, instead of honesty, I put the word trust, because that's my biggest value, and I said that needed to be a part of my map. And so it's huge. And your values, it's basically the way that it was explained to me, is your values, your subconscious is always trying to like achieve things, and when you give it a group of values with an intention, you're subconsciously going to try and like achieve these values and complete these values in order to achieve the goal. And so I'm seeing how that's working. It's been a lot of fun. And also using the values deck of cards, one thing that I did last year and that I want to get into is I would pick 7 cards for the week, and those were kind of the values that I would focus on. And so if you have an opportunity to buy a deck of cards, I would highly recommend it. And doing a conceptual map, specifically a full map, is for anybody who wants to live the life that they want to live. By living by your values, it creates you, like, it gives you freedom and flexibility to live your life the way that you want to live.
Thank you.
So yeah, for Sunil, I made him a clone of the server. The only things he has access to right now are the cards, and he's got his own blank database and his own blank website to support.
Hi, Eliza.
Hello.
I'm just getting something here for a sec.
Okay. Yeah, sorry, I got the time mixed up there, Sunil. But I hope this was the original time you were thinking it was. I know it's pretty early for you.
Yeah, it's 9, but no problem.
Okay. What I did is I just set up basically like a blank development area on the server for you, and included all the cards, like all the value lens cards, so that you could integrate them into whatever you're working with. And I guess we had about you kind of probably wanted to focus on like the components and just start from scratch, like do all the design yourself and kind of like work out how it should look and then build from there, I think is what we talked about yesterday.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So I remember, just to remind everyone, I guess yesterday we're talking about how we're building this communications platform, and we're going to be testing it with the LISIEL group of 144 people, and then so that's mostly finished. I'm going to finish that over the next day or two, hopefully here. But there's another component of that comes after that they're going to be testing for us as well, and we haven't actually built that yet. But Elijah has all the he knows how it needs to function and stuff. So if you're interested in doing that, we could start you off with that project is kind of what we were thinking.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay. So one thing we could do just while Elijah's getting set up, if you send me your email address on LinkedIn, I could send you an email with just like the FTP login stuff for the server.
Okay.
And also, do you use Discord at all, Sabino?
Yeah, I use Discord.
Okay, so we do have also like a Discord group. I'll send you an invite. So, you know, if you got any questions, just like, or you want to show us something, you know, kind of right away, like me, either I or Elijah is usually online.
Okay.
So it's just an easy way for us to talk to you as well.
So do you want me to describe what I think the project is?
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I'll hand it over to Elijah here to kind of get into specifics here. And I'll send you that email while we're talking about.
Okay, if you can kind of like take a look at that. That's called the Synergy Wheel. And that's has stewardship, research, infrastructure, learning, operations, creativity, synergy, services, marketing, and communication. See, the idea is this is a universal business system that can be programmed with values. So every one of the 12 teams is going to go through an exercise where they're going to create a value system. And this is actually going to be a massive part of the whole software system is this particular part, because this is where organizations choose their value system. Now, so what we want is we want this interface where these are blank, and then we'll have a way to press a button and either go choose your value where you get all the values that are available, or random. And I think maybe we could show you that. Do you want to show him that in the chat room, Maker?
Sorry, I was muted. Yeah, that's fine. Can you make it up again?
What's that? Oh, make you the... Sorry.
So I'll just take a moment to load here, but I you're wanting me to show him the card sets, right? Is that right, Elijah?
Say again.
You want me to send this? So here is this kind of thing that we showed you originally as well. Let me just skip a little bit ahead here. So here you have the value lenses. There's quite a lot of them, as you can see, right? I've given you access to all of these on your development end of the server anyway. Just to kind of show you what we're talking about here. So these ones are the value lenses. You'll notice on the bottom of each of them, it says value lens. So that's the type of ones that these are. And there's, I think 144, is that right?
There's about 100, but there could be 200 or 300 actually at some point, but.
Okay. Those are the value lenses. And then the other type is the conversation type. These are actually subdivided into different categories, you can say here.
Those are the same learning. Those are the same categories that are on the Synergy Wheel.
Yeah.
Research infrastructure.
So we could go to say stewardship, and each of them have a few of these.
I don't think that's important for what we've got to do here. Maybe we should just stick to
Okay, yeah. So you could just pick a random one here. And then the conceptual lenses, again, there's basically there's three types from my understanding, and the conversation types and the conceptual lenses are both categorized in these different categories. Here's some examples again. And sorry, Elijah, what are you
asking? No, we need to just stick to this. I just wanted you to show the values and then showing random versus choice.
Okay.
That's it.
Okay.
Could you go back to the values and go back to the random and the choice?
Okay. Oh, sorry.
You'd have this thing built today with all these meetings. Okay, so right there, you have the choice between random and choosing, right?
Yeah.
You want to just press on both just to kind of show?
Oh, okay, here's random. And you can pick another random one if you want. You can accept it or you can cancel that and instead use the choose method, which we kind of showed you before.
Right, so the reason I'm pointing that out is these, where my finger is pointing right now, there's a place for a value in each one of these green conduits. So, what I'd like you to do is to take those values and to create a choice or random for each one of these.
Okay.
And then there'll be a button where you'll go like, you could randomly choose a whole value system or choose a whole value system. You press the button when it's done, and then this thing gets printed as a PNG. It gets printed as a PDF. There's a way to change the picture in the background. There's a way to change the name at the top, right? So this is the every one of the 12 teams is going to create one of these value systems within 3 weeks, I think. So there's a potentiality, like we're going to have this integrated into what's about to occur. So are you okay? This is the project. It's a very exciting project. This thing is like massive. Like on your portfolio, if you've done this, believe me, within 5 years, the whole world might know your name. What's
so,
you live inside a temple?
Yeah, I live inside a temple, near a temple.
So they're always ringing the bells?
That's only in the morning. They're closed during the day.
Okay. So do you think you have the, like, I can make the pieces for you and send them to you over one by one,
yeah,
and then you put them together and make it work, right?
Yeah, I can make it. So basically what I have to do is take these values, right, behind you in the wheels, right, those values,
yeah,
and user have to choose, user can either choose randomly or select as he wishes, right? That's so. So, what I have to do is exactly make us UI, right? That in which user can either choose those values randomly or just select any option if they want.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Like pretty much everything is going to be fixed except the values which get chosen. And then we'll have this get chosen, the background picture gets chosen, and might be some other things which aren't that important right now. But
okay.
Is this within your capacity of to do so?
Yeah.
Yeah?
I can do it.
Okay, because there's going to be four levels of this at some point. So we're going to just, whatever we do, we're going to copy it. Obviously, it'll just be a different color here, different words. But just so you know, whatever you're building is going to be a template for three more levels. But what we want is essentially this. Like, we're going to have this up on the screen, and they all probably tomorrow maybe create the real screen for you. Exactly.
Okay.
And then I guess like with Noah, right? Like I break it down into the pieces. I send you all the pieces and then you make it. Is that kind of it, Nova?
Yeah, I think that makes sense. I mean, if I were to interpret the instructions here at this point, I think what we want is, something similar to, you know, this kind of simple setup where they have, there's some sort of wheel in the middle of the screen that looks like the one that's behind Elijah. It's got the components in it. I'm assuming we're going to send you that wheel so that you can, you know, reference it and see it. And then in the conduits that connect each of the things, we want to be able to put, one of the lenses, either a random one or a choice one. And that's basically the whole UI at this point. And that will connect to other things later, but this is like kind of the first step. So like just literally a circle in the middle of the screen that allows them to do that is all we need to actually start with. If that's, if that makes sense to you.
Thanks for clearing that up there, Noah.
I think that's right, right?
Yeah. Except it's not a box, it's round.
Yeah, we need the circle in the middle.
Yeah.
So, okay, what are you thinking at this point, Sunil? Does this make sense to you? Does this sound good? Is this a good place to start?
Yeah, okay. Yeah, it's on.
Okay. So if you can send me your email on LinkedIn, I will email you all the details also. And,
sure.
And Elijah, can you send me that synergy wheel again right now, just so I can throw it into the email?
Sure.
And then I'll put it all together talking here. Okay. And sorry, I think I asked you before, you have Discord, right?
Yeah, I have Discord.
Okay, so, yeah, I put the link in the Discord, or the Discord link in the email as well. And we just use the private channel on there called developers or development. So it's easy. Okay, and yeah, I guess so you kind of have an idea what you you can start on at least for us. How do you think you'll build it? Do you think you're gonna use React or you just wanna use like native JavaScript and basic stuff now? Or what do you think is your approach?
I think I'll go with React since I can start from scratch, right? It's better to start from a technology that we can use later at later stages. It's really easy to spin, right?
Okay, yeah. Okay, perfect. So I'm just sending you the email right now. You should have it in a moment. And then I think I asked you before, but I've forgotten what FTP client do you use?
Can you repeat that?
What FTP client do you use? Notepad++ or something like that?
I currently don't use those, but yeah. So which one do you use?
I would recommend Notepad++. Plus, it's simple. It connects to FTP pretty easily. I'll just throw a link for that too.
Okay, sure. Thanks.
Okay, so yeah, you should have the email there, I think, now. And I'll send you a link to Notepad++. Okay. If you want to join the Discord server and maybe download Notepad, you can connect to the servers. See, you know, you'll have access to all the lenses, the cards, and you can start whenever you want. I guess is the idea.
I'm just making the blank of the wheel right now. So I'll just send it over to you, Noah, and you can pass it on.
Oh, I've already actually sent him the one you just sent me.
I know, but it's not usable. But I'm sending one that can actually be usable.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Sunil, I guess, are you going to, do you imagine that you're going to take this wheel and make it work, or you're going to recreate it with CSS and HTML?
Actually, I was thinking about that. I'm not sure at this point, but I will try. I'll first try with CSS before using those assets.
Okay, well, we'll send you them anyway, just in case. But yeah, that might be the way to go too. I'm not entirely sure. That's why.
You're saying you could make it based upon just that, what I sent?
Yeah, it's a circle, right? We just need two circles. Yeah, we can, but it's better if you send me the assets also on this.
Yeah. Okay, that makes sense. Okay, I'll send you a second email with that in it as well. Other than that, is there anything that you think you need also? And did you get my email already?
Yeah, I got the one.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Well. So I'll sit there when a few minutes. Otherwise, yeah, we're stoked. This is a big piece of what we're trying to do. So. I think I can speak for Elijah and say we're both pretty excited.
He's always speaking for me.
If something comes up, shoot us a message. Obviously, the time difference here, like 3 o'clock where I am, 3 p.m., it's what? Or 3:30 p.m. here. It's 8:30 and Elijah is at night. So the time difference is always a factor, but we got people working from a few different places, so it's not a big deal.
Yeah, well, we can have it. So I guess that's it for now.
Yeah, unless you got any other questions, we'll arrange another meeting kind of later on in the next week or something, like in a few days or a week.
So I got a UI question. Like, if can you share the wheel again? So initially, that wheel will be empty, right? Those values in the UI for that.
Yeah.
And user can select a value. So when user selects one of the values from there, will that value appear in the center or in the outer circle?
The value will appear in the green conduit. They'll
in the center, all right?
Like they'll appear where they are now. Like the green conduit is the place for the value.
Okay.
Yeah. So the circular cards on the outside, they stay there?
Sorry,
I was trying to clarify it. Like Elijah, it's like marketing, stewardship, research, those all stay where they are?
Yeah.
Okay, so it's just the green conduits that the word changes. So or do you apply the whole circular lens on top of
it? No, you would have to somehow, okay, if we have compassion we choose the circle word, but then the only the word compassion goes in there. Right?
Oh, okay.
We could drag and drop it if there was some way to take the word compassion from the circle, right?
I guess in the end, the people will be given a choice of those lenses that we saw, but then when you actually select one, whether you drag and drop it or click on it or whatever, just the word will end up in those conduits.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I'll try to create an initial design and send you over the LinkedIn or Discord to get your feedback.
Okay, yeah, perfect. That sounds good. Okay, well, yeah, thanks. Awesome. We'll stand by and see what you can do.
Thanks.
All right. See you later. Great to see you, Sunil.
It's great to see you too. Yeah, thanks. Bye.
Okay. I think that went well.
Just funny because this could be the most important. This is the thing, if I could say I wanted the most over all the years, is just to do what we're about to do here with this guy.
Just good. Just,
like, and if he can do it, like it's like, holy shit, man.
I think he can do it. Yeah.
Well, it's not I don't think it's that difficult of a thing. It's just to do it. But, I mean, once once we have, you can go online and choose a value and pop it in. And I mean, that's going to be the thing that goes across the world. And then click on the value, and then we've got a whole bunch of teachers LinkedIn, right? It's, you want to learn clarity? Ain't so easy. It ain't so easy.
Okay, well, don't forget to send me the empty one.
Yeah.
And then I'll send it off to him, and it sounds like he's going to be working on it and send us something on Discord soon.
Really?
Sweet. That's what he said. Yeah, he said, I'll start working on it, and I'll send you a link on Discord when I have something to show you.
Before I get the whole fucking thing built by all these guys across the world. That's true. Planetary Guardians gets shit done. Do you know what I told you? The guidance I got was, you got to start with no money. You have to start with nothing. And then you build value. Like, whatever, you know, we've got so much value here, and it's just because, you know, we didn't waste it with $1 million of funding and just wasting
money. Yeah. Well, we know the old adage, right? If you build it, they will come. We're inventing the new one. If we get volunteers, they will build it. I don't know. I don't know what the name will be, but that's the other thing that we're discovering kind of by trial and error here. Okay, awesome. I think I can speak for both of us when I say this has been a good meeting.
Well, I haven't spoken the whole time, and I think I can speak for a lot. Who's this guy? Oh yeah, he's the designer.
Awesome. Okay, so hey, before you go, let's just make sure we know what's happening tomorrow. We've got a few meetings tomorrow.
Tomorrow?
Yeah.
What?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, of course. That's how this gets done.
Who?
Okay, so let's see here.
All I got is Ezekiel on Monday.
Ezekiel on Monday. We have, let me just try to read my notes here.
Stop the meetings and get the freaking thing finished. Fuck.
Well, we got to get these now because we have to get Muhammad to do something and Thabo. We got two other people here that aren't actually in place yet. They said yes, but they haven't actually started to do anything yet. So that's the last meeting, just like the meeting today. Get them on a project and then we can sit back and wait.
Okay. Okay. So maybe you can get them going.
No, you got to be there.
What time?
We got to work with it right now. I'm just like, what the hell are we doing? let's see.
You know what? We got to get the right project mod. We got to get right set up. I got to do that tomorrow. I've been slacking.
Yeah, get it set up.
Because I ran out of the free one and they stopped your access to all your good shit.
Oh, yeah.
God, at some point we're gonna be like, we have to be legitimate.
Yeah,
this is gonna make
us one of the things you need to do, I think, is have you ever incorporated or started a, like, have you ever registered a business name with Canada?
No,
you need to do that.
All that business shit is stuff I hate. We got to get someone
on. It's really easy.
We got to get someone on the team to do all that shit. That's not my.
I can also do that. I've done it a bunch of times.
Really?
It may be more difficult from here, but I'm not sure. I have an account online and stuff.
You got enough.
Basically, you just need to come up with three names for the company. That's the first step. Is you come up with three names, in the order that you want them. So they'll search for the first one if it's taken, they'll search for the second one if it's taken, they'll search for the third one. Otherwise you get whatever one is first available.
Yeah.
That costs $45. It takes a couple of weeks for them to do it, maybe longer. And then after you have that, then you own the business name, like Planetary Guardians. I think you should just go for Planetary Guardians right now.
Hmm.
Then we'll have a business name. And from that, you can either incorporate a nonprofit, corporation, a sole proprietor, partnership, or a co-op. Mm-hmm. And that's another piece of paper. It's like $170 to do one of the regular ones. A corporation is more money. I would suggest that we do a nonprofit.
Fuck a nonprofit, man. Anyway, I don't want to talk about this stuff right now.
Okay, well, you need to do that because when it comes time to, I already had a couple of people for the media design. People said, the corporation, are you this, are you that? I'm like, well, kind of in the process. And they're like, I'm not interested.
Share knowledge community. It's a new paradigm.
Yeah.
Anyway, we'll talk about that later. That's got to be figured out, but I don't want to talk about it right now.
All right. Okay. It's fine. So tomorrow we got the South African guy, Thabo.
Okay. What time?
Or Thabo, Thabo. At hold on, I gotta work this out. It will be at 2:00 your time, 2 p.m.
Okay.
And he's already signed on. This is just the second one. Then we've got Mohammed from India. Let me just double check him. Where I have him at. He's at 9 p.m. tomorrow.
Okay.
And he has a really thick accent, and also his microphone really sucks. But he's like 19. Just graduated from high school. He knows some of this coding stuff, but he's got no paperwork. So he's a shoo-in for what we're trying to do. But yeah, it's really hard to understand, especially with his microphone being so shit. We'll see.
Well, I think we
should. That's it. I only got those two meetings.
And you're going to finish it tomorrow.
That's the intent. I'll try to do that today and tomorrow. Yeah. And I'll let you know, we'll probably have 3 or 4 more interviews tomorrow for the digital media person. But I'm still waiting on some message backs for that. So we'll see. They seem to be a little bit harder to get on board. We'll see.
Okay. Okay. Excellent work, my friend.
All right. That feels good. I think we're making progress.
I think so.
Or at least we're getting other people to make progress for us. It's great.
No, I think today was a huge day. Huge day.
Yeah, I think so too.
Good work. Good work. And we'll see you tomorrow.
All right. Can you send me those Zoom links when you have a chance for those 2 meetings?
Okay.
Okay, cool.